Hello friends and welcome back to another video from Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. In this video we are going to talk about another important organelle, that is Golgi body. So in the last video we have talked about the endoplasmic reticulum, and the endoplasmic reticulum is attached to the nucleus. It means that it is very close to the nucleus. If this is the nucleus and this board is a cell, then to the outer nuclear membrane the ER is directly connected like this. Okay, so the endoplasmic reticulum is directly connected with the outer nuclear membrane. So it would be seen something like that. Okay, it can be embedded with ribosomes, and if ribosomes are present on endoplasmic reticulum, it is known as RER, because the ribosomes will give rough appearance to the endoplasmic reticulum. So it is rough endoplasmic reticulum. And if ribosomes are not present, it is called as SER, that is smooth endoplasmic reticulum. If there is no ribosome, the appearance will be smooth, so it is SER. The RER is majorly responsible for the protein synthesis. Why? Because ribosomes are the protein factory of our cell. They are responsible for the synthesis of protein, and after synthesizing protein, they will send the proteins to the lumen of endoplasmic reticulum. And SER is responsible majorly for the lipid synthesis. Okay, so RER for protein, SER for lipid. Now the protein is already present in the lumen of endoplasmic reticulum, so it is processed here, but the processing is not completed yet. Use thoda aur process karna padega, aur use aur process karne ke liye hamare paas ek aur organelle hai, which is called as the Golgi complex or simply the Golgi body. So we need Golgi body to process the proteins completely. Okay, let's say this is something like Golgi. Ye hamara Golgi body hai. Okay, so just near the nucleus Golgi body is also present, because the nucleus will be attached to the ER, or we can say the ER will be always attached to the nucleus, kyunki uski outer membrane कंटिन्यूअस है विद द एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम. नाउ द प्रोटीन्स जो कि राइबोसोम पर बनेंगे विल श्योरली गो इनटू द एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम फॉर सम प्रोसेसिंग. दैट प्रोसेसिंग इज बेसिकली कॉल्ड एज एन लिंक्ड ग्लाइकोसाइलेशन. नाउ ग्लाइकोसाइलेशन मींस ग्लाइको सिंपली मींस एडिशन ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट. सो to protein chain you are adding some sort of sugar molecules, okay, some carbohydrate molecules, and those carbohydrate molecules are the signals, okay, ki is protein ko jana kahan pe hai. For example, if there is some protein which need to go to the lysosome, then it will be containing a signal which will tell Golgi body that this protein need to go to lysosome. So the Golgi will send that protein to the lysosome only, not anywhere else. Okay, so there are very specific proteins in our body which used to work in very specific environment. Some proteins are made for plasma membrane, so they will surely got integrated in the plasma membrane only. Some will go to the endosome, they will become lysosome then, and some will present in the cytosol, some will be a part of Golgi, and some will be a part of like endoplasmic reticulum. So all those things usually happen with the help of some signals. Okay, these are the sugar molecules which are attached to the protein with help of N-linked glycosylation in endoplasmic reticulum. In Golgi, further processing is needed. Okay, this is the processing that is done in the endoplasmic reticulum. But when this signal comes to the Golgi, it will even further processed to a very specific manner so that it can go to the specific sites only. Okay. So let's talk about the structure of Golgi now. So the structure of Golgi is basically formed of cisternes. Cisternae simply means these tubule-like structure. ये जो tube-like structures आप लोग देख रहे हैं, these are basically called as cisternae. And these cisternes are hold parallel to each other. Okay, this is one cisternae, this is another, and so on. So these are hold parallel to each other, and they used to give rise to vesicles. Okay, the membrane-bound vesicles. So this will bud off like from here, and it will form a vesicle. That vesicle will transport the protein to another part of Golgi, and after that it will be budded off from there, which is containing the protein, and it will fuse with the desired organelle. For example, this is lysosome and this is the protein which is required in lysosome. तो यहां से क्या होगा, वो प्रोटीन बड ऑफ हो जाएगा और आपका प्रोटीन लाइसोसोम में जाकर इस ल्यूमन में पहुंच जाएगा. ओके, वेयर इट इज डिजायर्ड. सो द प्रोटीन्स आर ट्रांसपोर्टेड बाय दिस पर्टिकुलर मैकेनिज्म इन विच द पैकेजिंग इज मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट एंड द पैकेजिंग इन फॉर्म ऑफ मेम्ब्रेन बाउंड वसाइकल इज बेसिकली डन बाय द गोल्जी कॉम्प्लेक्स. So the protein which are synthesized and sent into the lumen of ER will now come to Golgi, and that's why it is obvious ki ye dono organelle aaspaas present hongi, and that's why endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi are present nearby. Okay, and after that the Golgi will package that protein and it will send it to the destination where it is required. So the name Golgi apparatus, or we can say Golgi body, is on the name of scientist who discovered Golgi for the very first time. Okay, that is known as Camillo Golgi. So Camillo Golgi ke naam pe Golgi body ya fir Golgi apparatus ka naam rakha gaya hai. And these are basically the densely stained body which are present near the nucleus. That's why I have told you they are present near nucleus or near endoplasmic reticulum, because their functions are a little bit coordinated. Okay, so they are formed up of cisternae which give rise to vesicles as well, and these cisternae are arranged in a parallel manner. The diameter of a cisternae is 0.5 to 1 micron, okay, or micrometer. So itna inka diameter hota hai cisternae ka, jo ki parallelly attached hoti hai, and they give rise to vesicles and they used to send proteins to their desired places. After that they are present near nucleus or near ER because they need to take proteins from them. And after that, they need to fully process those proteins and they used to send it to the desired place. After that, there are two different phases of Golgi. The first one is cis and the second one is trans. So the phase that is going to be near the ER is cis phase. And it is known as the forming phase, or you can call it the entry phase. Entry means the proteins which are formed in ER or endoplasmic reticulum will now come to the Golgi from this phase only. They cannot directly go to the trans phase or to the this cisternae. They need to be sequentially sent to each one of them. So they will come from this phase only, which is known as the entry phase or cis phase. After that, this is the last phase, which is known as trans or maturing phase or exit phase. Okay, so from this the vesicles will exit to the desired place. So the vesicle will be generated like this and they will be sent to different kind of cisternae. After that they will come to the final cisternae, which is the exit point. From the exit point they will be diverted to different kind of places where they are required. For example, the protein can go to the plasma membrane, the protein can go to the lysosome or to any other place. Okay, some proteins are retrieved back from this cis phase to the ER, which are required in ER, wo fully process hokar dobara ER mein chale jayenge. Okay, so there are some retrieval signals as well, jo ki batayenge ki bhai is protein ko ER mein jana hai, so wo ER mein chali jayegi wapas, otherwise sare ke sare samne chalti rahengi. Aur kuch aise proteins hote hain which need to be secreted out of the cell. Okay, so for that there are some signals as well, jahan par kya hoga, they will form the vesicles, that vesicles will fuse with the plasma membrane and the plasma membrane will send those proteins outside the cell. So there are different destinations, there can be plasma membrane, lysosome, different organelles, there can be ER also, and after that there are some resident proteins which need to be present in Golgi, so they will be retained in the Golgi. Okay, and after that if the protein need to be secreted out of the cell, it will bound with the plasma membrane and it will be then secreted out, right? So these are the two different phases of Golgi complex. Now let's talk about the important functions which I have already told you. Lekin ab yahan par specifically baat karenge. The very first thing is packaging. The Golgi is responsible for the synthesis of various glycoproteins, glycolipids, and in case of plants, polysaccharides. Okay, सो जो बन रहा है उसका ट्रांसपोर्ट होना भी बहुत जरूरी है, एंड फॉर दैट ट्रांसपोर्ट प्रोसेस दे नीड सम व्हीकल. फॉर एग्जांपल अगर आपको कहीं पे जाना है देन यू नीड इधर बाइक और ऑटो और कार वट एवर यू वॉन्ट टू यूज. तो यहां पर वो जो कार है वो है मेम्ब्रेन बाउंड वसाइकल. सो ऑल द प्रोटीन्स विच आर सिंथेसाइज will be present in this membrane bound vesicle and will be transported to different destinations. Okay, so it helps in the packaging of different things which are formed in Golgi or which are come into Golgi for processing to the desired places. After that it is present near ER because it helps in the protein processing. ER is linked with the N-linked glycosylation. Jo N-linked glycosylation hogi wo endoplasmic reticulum mein hogi. पर गोल्जी में ओ लिंक्ड ग्लाइकोसाइलेशन भी होती है. ओके, ओ लिंक्ड ग्लाइकोसाइलेशन. सो फॉर द फाइनल प्रोसेसिंग प्रोसेस दे आर प्रेजेंट इन गोल्जी फ्रॉम विच दे आर पैकेज्ड एंड ट्रांसपोर्टेड. आफ्टर दैट प्रोसेसिंग एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी सेड कि प्रोटीन प्रोसेसिंग एज वेल एज जो ग्लाइकोप्रोटीन और ग्लाइकोलिपिड बनेंगे वो भी यहीं से ट्रांसपोर्ट होंगे. सो इट इज बेसिकली डिजायर्ड फॉर sending all the important proteins to the desired destinations. कहीं भी कोई भी protein जा रहा है so उसके पीछे का जो main role है वो Golgi के पास है. For example अगर lysosome में एक protein को जाना है then there is a specific signal for it, mannose 6-phosphate. Okay, mannose is just a monosaccharide just like glucose. So mannose की 6th position पे, I mean 6th position पे जो mannose होगा वहां पर आपको phosphate attach करना है. So there are different kind of sugars attached to the protein like this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's say this is the 6th sugar and it is mannose. Okay. So at this position, phosphate is added. And now this signal will tell the Golgi to send this protein to the lysosome. So the lysosome will be getting some proteins which are having only this signal. So each and every protein is sent to its perfect place just because of these signals which are present on their glycoprotein moieties. Glyco means sugar and this is the protein to which this moiety is attached. So har signal kahin na kahin sahi tarike se organelle mein protein ko bhejne ka kaam karta hai aur wo jo packaging hoti hai uske liye Golgi responsible hai. So Golgi is one of the most important organelles. In the next lecture we are going to talk about lysosome in detail. That what is the structure of lysosome, what are different functions of lysosome. So I hope that you got this video very well. Agar aap logo ko pasand aaye then do hit like button, share this video with your friends, subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for sure. Thank you so much.